Oh, Roger that. Roger that. Let's see here. Why do you go online with that? Do you need to go online with that? I thought that would be a direct shot from the headset to the receiver.
Not from the headset to the receiver. Just wireless. It's more convenient to be able to, walk around a little bit inside the RV. We live in a motorhome, so I thought maybe I could make that work. But wireless is so much more convenient. I'll put it that way.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. But you don't really mean online. You just mean that thing is on. It doesn't really have to connect to the internet, Roger.
To the microphone plug, and it goes into the back of the base unit, and the base unit transmits the Bluetooth wireless signal to the headset anywhere within about 150 feet. So it's really quite convenient when it works. But the problem is that something is blowing it offline, and I can't for the life of me figure it out. So I've just taken that out of the circuit. You might remember. Last time we talked about it, you remarked that it sounded a little hot, and I might have the gain a little bit too high on it and the radio, so I kind of wrestled with that. But it's very sensitive to that, so I'm not sure what's causing it.
Roger, Roger. Does it pair up normal? A Bluetooth pair, does that work normal?
Bluetooth pair, does that work normal? Yeah, that part of the function works very well. It connects right up like it's supposed to. No problem there.
All right. Could be you have a new buddy somewhere in the neighborhood that has a Bluetooth on the same frequency, and his is a little bit stronger?
His is a little bit stronger? Well, if there is, I don't know about it. I'm usually on the thing at 7 in the morning. On 40 meters with the RV service net, 7191.
Roger. No, I mean on your Bluetooth frequency, on your Bluetooth pair frequency, Roger.
Your Bluetooth pair frequency, Roger. Oh, I see. Yeah, there are other Bluetooth devices in the RV here, telephones and so forth, and I think the printer as well. But they've been on there the whole time. I've never not had them, I'll put it that way.
Roger, have you noticed anybody new, any new Bluetooth frequencies or IDs?
Frequencies or IDs? Well, that is a possibility. There's people in the RV park here that come and go frequently, so that's very possible. I wouldn't know how to go tell them not to use their Bluetooth device or how to isolate them, but yes, that is a possibility. Hadn't thought of that.
Roger. Although you would probably have a log-on problem, a pair problem, if you did have that situation going on. Although if they were to come on after you had logged in, that would, you would not see them. It would just maybe... try to grab your frequency or cause interference, Roger.
Cause interference, Roger.
Roger, Roger. You know what? I'll pay attention to that. I'll try it out next time, and we'll see what time and how long it is before it goes offline and what may have occurred to cause it. I appreciate that. I know you're coming up on the magical hour here, so I'll hush. I'll just be listening. K4ATW, back to you, Jim.
Roger, Roger there. Let me get together here. I've got a couple of things I've got to do yet. I'm about halfway, or two-thirds of the way in my checklist, Roger.
Two-thirds of the way in my checklist, Roger.
Roger, Roger. Clear. K4ATW, clear with KC9VKV.
If you want to jump back in later on, after we get going on the show, maybe we can discuss it some more.
Sounds good. I'll appreciate that. K4HEW.
KC9ZKB.
KC9ZKB.
Check, check, PASDR.
Check, check, PASDR.
This is KC9VKV, showtime 90 seconds. Check, check, Boone, North Carolina.
Check, check, Boone, North Carolina.
Check, check, New York. Check, check, PA.
Check, check, PA.
Check, check, Georgia.
Check, check, Georgia. Check, check, Georgia.
Check, check, Virginia.
Check, check, Virginia.
And good afternoon, everyone. This is Kilo Charlie 9, Victor Kilo Victor. My name is Jim, and this is the Friday afternoon QSO VLOC network. This is a directed network, and I am net control. If at any time during this net should an emergency arise, please notify net control, and we'll stand by and allow those in need to access this frequency. Is there any priority or emergency traffic at this time? And hearing nothing, we will continue. This net is all about ham radio and being all that you can be. That's what our QSO VLOC network is all about, trying to help people achieve the best sounding station possible. Thanks for dropping by. FYI, my background is 50 years in commercial broadcasting, where a lot of big bucks are spent on audio processing equipment and getting it set up correctly to get the best sounding station possible. Well, long story short, when I became a ham radio operator, I could hear immediately a large discrepancy in on-air technical proficiency. A lot of stations were running with very poor mic equalization, very muddy, with little articulation. And as I continued to work stations, I realized most of the stations were also running very low average peak modulation, many around 30% of average peak modulation. So with my background, I felt I could help. Or at least try. I knew that most modern-day ham transceivers did have enough onboard processing equipment to be able to overcome most all of the problems. And so I started the QSO VLOC network with the phrase, if you have a radio you want to check out, give us a shout. And today, we're currently featuring over 2,800 QSO VLOC air check recordings. And you can access these recordings by going to YouTube and doing a call letter search for KC9VKV, followed by the word logbook. That's Kilo Charlie 9, Victor Kilo Victor, followed by the word logbook. And we also have a newer series called KC9VKV Highlights. That's Kilo Charlie 9, Victor Kilo Victor, followed by the word highlights on a YouTube search. These are some of our less technical and more human nature philosophical kinds of QSOs. That's KC9VKV, followed by the word highlights on a YouTube search. Both KC9VKV Logbook and KC9VKV Highlights are segments of our main YouTube homepage of Jim's Radio Story, where we celebrate a 50-year career in commercial broadcasting, a 50-year journey from a 5-watt pirate radio station as a 12-year-old to production director of a major 50,000-watt AM broadcast facility. And the thing that makes this truly a unique story is that I have all the actual masters from all along the way. Over 2,600 shows, including many full-length major music concerts and radio documentaries. You'll have to check it out and subscribe. Jim's Radio Story on a YouTube search. Our mission statement for the QSO VLOC network is to establish a higher technical level of radio transmissions of the human voice by the intelligent utilization of available electronics in current amateur radio transceivers. Our setup, while generic in nature, converts the average 10 dB dynamic range transmitter with an average 30% of peak modulation to a much fuller 3 dB dynamic range with an average 80 to 85% of peak modulation. This substantial boost in audio transmit level is extremely beneficial in high noise levels and heavy QRM. It allows you to punch through when others fail. The second part of our transmitter setup has to do with proper mic equalization. We're looking to optimize the transmitted voice for a higher degree of intelligibility through the use of EQ patterns that bring out the articulation aspects of the human voice. Again, why need to hear the voice if you can't understand the words? Also this afternoon, on the receive side, we're running 5 Internet SDR receivers, monitoring New York, Pennsylvania, Georgia, and Virginia specifically. And in addition, we're running our new number 5 Hocus Pocus Internet SDR receiver, loaded with 50 additional pre-programmed Internet SDR locations spread out over 20 states across the eastern half of the United States, trying to get the best copy from our 100-watt friends. And today, our local receiver is running 3 large 10-foot vertical magnetic loop antennas, one aimed at 0 degrees, one aimed at 90 degrees, and the number 3 is aimed at 134 degrees. These are run as a directional scanner array with a manual voting system 6-position rotary selector. Also today, on the transmit side, we'll be running our NOSWR specially oriented resonant-tuned dipole antenna. One leg of this resonant-tuned dipole antenna runs broadside to Montreal, Canada. The other leg runs broadside to Miami, Florida. As we were constructing our station, our mantra was 20 over from Montreal to Miami with a hotspot through the Carolinas. And although conditions may vary, the general performance of this antenna supports its mission. Also today, we'll be running our input source indicator. So when we switch from an Internet SDR receiver to our local receiver, you'll be able to hear the switch and see the switch. You'll have to check it out on our YouTube QSO VLOG video. And as we come together for another Friday afternoon QSO VLOG network, let us pause just a moment for the amateur radio operator's prayer. Lord, we pray for clear 20 over S9 communications today. Let all our transmissions fill the air and reach their destinations QSA5 to be understood by all. And as we pray for good radio conditions, let us also pray for good human conditions. During this time of pandemic that has challenged us all, we pray that you'll protect everyone, especially our elderly. And also, Lord, we seek your divine intervention to bring peace to a very divided United States. As we go through a very conflicting time in America's history, with dark clouds all around, we pray that you'll reduce life's daily political QRM between our brothers and sisters. And through your love and guidance, show us the way to find peace and harmony. Help us to communicate with one another 20 over S9. Thank you, Lord, and God bless and protect America. Amen. To continue, since this part of the band has many nets trying to operate in a very confined area, I would appreciate all stations checking into our QSO VLOG net to keep their band pass to no wider than 100 to 2900. And again, please, no wider than 100 to 2900.